Hello children, good morning. Now today we are going to read poem The Wind. Yes, this poem is written by Subramanya Bharati and he wrote that poem in Tamil and that is translated by A.K. Ramanujan. Okay, before going into the poem, let us know about these two poets. Okay, now he is Subramanya Bharati. And he fought for, see if you look at that year 1882 to 1921, that means freedom struggle was going on at that period, right? So he participated in many struggles and he wrote many poems inspiring everybody, okay? Now, finally, to know his patriotism, this sentence is enough. So without writing anything, I just quoted this because this shows his love towards the country and his feeling how towards his country and how he felt when this independence struggle was going on. Look at that. She has 30 crores of faces, but her heart is one. The desire each and everybody feels in these 30 crores of people is only one desire. What was that? Independence. And she speaks 18 languages, yet her mind is one. So the strong desire which has in each and everybody in those days, that was clearly depicted in these two beautiful lines. Yes. Now next one is this A.K. Ramanujan, who has translated that poem in English in 1929 to 1993. And his full name is Attipati Krishnaswamy Ramanujan. And he was an Indian poet and also scholar and Indian of Indian literature and who wrote both English and Kannada, and he knew English, Kannada and even Tamil languages, and these are the books what he has written: A Flowering Tree, Speaking of Shiva and Folk Tales from India. So now let's go to the poem and know what he has written in this beautiful and very it's not even information. We know everything whatever is there in the poem, but it makes us feel, yes, we have to be like that. Yes, we have to do something. We should not give up anything. That kind of spirit it fills in our mind when we start going through this poem. Very simple poem, very small lines, but the inspiration what it gives to us is immense. Now look at that. Wind, come softly. Don't break the shutters of the windows. Don't scatter the papers. Don't throw down the books on the shelf. Here is the full stop. So let us stop there for those four lines. So from these, wind, come softly. This is telling us, the poet is talking to the wind. So he is telling the wind. What is he telling the wind? Wind, come softly. Don't break the shutters of the windows. And don't scatter the papers. Don't throw down the books on the shelf. So he's telling the wind, please don't do that. Don't do that. But there, look what you have done. He's showing the things whatever the wind has done. There, look what you have done. You threw them all down. You tore the papers of the books. You brought rain again. And you are very clever at poking fun at weaklings. Frail, crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling hearts. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. So what he's telling? Look at the work what you have done. See, you tore the papers. You brought the rain again. And you are very clever at poking fun of weaklings. Making fun of those weak people. Weaklings means who are very weak. Frail, crumbling houses. You are going to crumble the houses which are very delicate. And then crumbling doors which are very delicate. The crumbling doors. You are crumbling even rafters. Rafters means that sloping roof, whatever will be there. No, when the wind blows very fast, they will be taken away in that wind. So those rafters and crumbling wood, crumbling bodies. Not only all those things, even human beings also. Crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling hearts. So he's telling, talking about all the destruction what the wind god wind is doing that. And The wind god winnows and crushes them all. Winnows and crushes them. Winnows. Winnows means, look at that picture. What they are doing? They are winnowing. So when you do like that, what happens? All that soft dust particles, hush, will come out and then the grain will fall at one place. So you are separating them actually. So there is a wind is helping you. So here, whatever you want, it will be there. Whatever you don't want, it will be thrown out. So the wind god winnows and crushes them all. Who are those that them refers to? That them refers to all those weak things there. Whoever are very weak, they will be crumbled. So now, he won't do what you tell. So what is he telling? You are not, he is not going to do whatever you tell him. He refers to the wind. Yes, he is not going to do whatever you tell. So come, let's build strong homes. So let us build homes, our homes very strong, so that the strong wind is not going to crush them. And let's join the doors firmly. Practice to firm the body. Make the heart steadfast. Steadfast means firm, strong. And do this and the wind will be friends with us. The wind blows out weak fires and makes strong fires roll like flourish. And his friendship is good. We praise him every day. Now look at that, what he is telling. So here, if you look at these things, he is telling us, let us be strong. Let us not be so weak that even the wind will crush away. So how? Let us make our homes strong and doors very, close the doors very firmly and make our bodies very strong and let us stand firm and don't think the wind will be, do this and wind, the wind will be friends with us. So if you can make friendship with the wind, then all these things will not happen. That means to make the friendship with the wind god, we should be very strong. If we are strong mentally, the wind god is not going to do anything. The wind blows out weak. So here he is telling, whoever are weak, the wind will blows out. The weak fires will be put out immediately. But again, if the fire is very strong, he makes strong fires roar and flourish. True, no, children? When the fire, it's not, it become very strong, when it is very little, and the little wind is enough to put out that. But when it is very strong, the more the wind blows, the more it becomes, it roars and spreads everywhere. So we have to be like that. If we are strong, all these will be nothing. So here, his friendship is good. We praise him every day. So in the entire poem, the wind is completely, it's not just the wind. The poet wanted to tell us that it's not the wind, it is about the problems or the difficulties what we are facing in our day-to-day life. So if we are strong, then these problems will is definitely going to help us to become a better person. We will really flourish. This weak fires, these small problems, petty problems are not going to destroy us when only when we are very strong. So in the entire poem, you can see that the wind is symbolically using to the problems what we are facing. And the strong fires and weak fires are telling that we should be very strong, like fire. If we are very weak, then it will be, we will collapse. We cannot get up. If we give up, the just because this problem is there, you can never achieve anything. So you may fail. Start again and do. You will really be successful and you will roar and flourish. So this is the poem, children. And I want all of you to read and understand the poem and try to write even the summary of that also. Now, as the poem is very simple, I thought of taking even the poetic devices also now only. So let us complete even the poetic devices. Now, if you look at the entire poem, you can find that the entire poem is, it did not, the poet did not follow any rhyming scheme, right? Or softly, lee sound, windows, sir sound, papers, shelf, down, books, again, weaklings, rafters, knives, hearts, small. So there is very particular pattern. He just got all the words, whatever, he just arranged them and looked at the meaning what he was going to convey. So the entire poem is written in did not follow any rhyme scheme. Next, anaphora. Anaphora is the repetition of the words in the beginning of the lines. So look at that. Don't break, don't scatter, don't throw, don't word is repeated there. And again, one more example. You tore the pages, you brought, you are very clever. So you is referred. So that is anaphora in this poem. Now, personification means giving human qualities to non-living things and nature things and animals and all that. So here the wind is personified and the wind is given human qualities. So he is talking to the wind. The poet is talking to the wind. So he has personified that. And then he is telling that all the things whatever the wind is doing. So again personified there. Okay, next, he won't do what? So here he is telling that again, giving personification. And he makes strong fires and his friendship is good. Every way, he is personified there. Now, repetition means the words that are repeated. So look here, crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, and crumbling hearts. The word crumbling is repeated so frequently. So it is giving us a proper picture how the wind is breaking everything. When you are listening to that, you can feel that the wind is blowing and it is crushing everything and crumbling everything, right? So the repetition is making us feel the disaster of what the wind is doing. Alliteration, the consonant sounds are repeated in the line. So here, wind, winnows, and what. These two are the things which are there to tell us that it is alliteration. Okay, now metaphor. Here, the wind god. Here, the wind is compared to a god. Wind god, winnows. Okay, and then the entire poem, if you, and here one more thing, weak fires, the problems what the people are facing and who are giving up. The fires are compared to the problems, hurdles, what we are facing that. So weak fires and strong fires, when we are very strong. So the fires are comparing to the people and the problems what they are facing. Now in the entire poem, if you see that the wind is again compared to the problems what we face in our day-to-day life. We may come across many problems in our life. So each and every problem and the way we feel when a problem is there in our life, like we will tell, please don't do this. No, don't break the shutters and windows. You are telling wind. And if you are facing any problem, please don't do that. Don't do this to me. I just don't want to face this kind of problem. We will be talking to the problem without our knowledge. So everywhere, entire poem, the wind is compared to the problems what we are facing in our day-to-day life. And symbolism, yes, symbolically also the entire poem, the wind is symbolically used to the hurdles what we are facing in our day-to-day life. Entire thing is there like that only. Okay, entire poem you can find that symbolism, wind is symbolically used for the problems, and even the weak fires and strong fires are talking about the fire is compared to the mindset of the people who are very weak and who are very strong, who are not able to face the problem and who are giving up the things and imagery. So when you are reading the poem, you can clearly get the picture of the wind roaring and destroying everything, and the books are thrown and the pages are torn. So you can almost everything in that thing, you can just get the picture of whatever is there in happening when the wind is blowing, right? So these are the 8 poetic devices, and I want all of you go through that, take a pause now and write first these poetic devices, and then afterwards write the summary of the poem. So first you write the poetic devices, that will give you proper idea, and your summary will be really very nice, because these poetic devices will make you feel the poem. So when you feel it, the way you write the summary will be different, children. So first do this part and then go and write the summary. I think you understood everything in this poem. Okay? Thank you.